For the guys out there that don't know the difference between fluorocarbon and monofilament, I'm going to compare it today. There are three main differences between monofilament and fluorocarbon. Number one, fluorocarbon has less stretch than monofilament. What that means is fluorocarbon is more sensitive as far as bite detection goes. It's more direct. Second of all, it is denser than monofilament. It has very much the same density as water. For that reason, it is less visible in water. Thirdly, it's harder, stronger, and has more abrasive resistant qualities than monofilament. There are various fluorocarbons on the market. I'm going to go through the ones that you see in front of you. First of all, the Kingfisher fluorocarbon. It ranges from 3.8 kilos to 33 kilos. The Kingfisher advanced fluorocarbon is great value for money. If you want to go up a notch in fluorocarbon, the Siglon FC is definitely the one to look at. Much, much better quality as far as durability goes. And the range ranges from 7.1 kilos to 30 kilos. Now, generally, where would you use fluorocarbon? Fluorocarbon is used in clean water conditions where basically the fish would be very, very skittish. And you don't want to spook them. So you can actually go down on the breaking strain that you are using. The fluorocarbon as well is a great abrasion resistant line. So if you're fishing in rocks and you need that abrasion resistance where you might be catching, for instance, eel-tail barbels, where they are actually hiding in rocks or rock cod, it is a very, very good as far as the rubbing ability goes. Fluorocarbon is definitely the way to go when targeting those kind of species. Or if you're hooking fish that have got very rough teeth, like tuna for instance, as you know, their teeth are very fine and very, very rough. So as far as a hook snoot goes, that would definitely be the option for catching tuna, is to use a fluorocarbon line.